Hey guys, welcome back to another Chris Nolte fishing video. I'm here, I'm gonna fish the pond with some finesse tactics. You know, I didn't catch them yesterday on the chatterbait. So why not change it up? So yes.
Hey guys, welcome back to another Chris Nolte fishing video. Today we're fishing, of course, the pond. We're fishing, we had a drop shot and a shaky head. We're fishing for a bunch of smaller bass. They were absolutely everywhere. Can't really find decent sized ones. We'll catch them all. I can catch them on a chatterbait yesterday because they're just small. All just very, very small. I'm gonna like hit this little area. There seems to be a bunch of fish here. So. Wheel tapping at it. Oh, see if we can get a bass though. Tap at this. Here we go, coming for it. Like a bunch in there. Ugh, front of the tree. Drop a shaky head down there. We should get him. I'll spin my rig in a little bit. But they're both pretty simple finesse rigs. Haven't been around the whole pond yet, so it's kind of hard to tell if there's big ones out yet or if it's just these little guys for now. I think I'm gonna move on to a different spot. Maybe if I just get under the shade and cast at him from there. Because there's so many fish. They're all gills though, I think. Well, there's decent bass. That's a decent like antler. Or a drop shot around. Ugh. I think I spooked him. I had to find, like, deep water or something. My corners would be... Both these corners would be dead. So you keep walking. And this corner should be something. Trout or the trout. Huh. I'm just up against these rocks. That's a deal still. I can find a big bass left on my bed. I'll fish it the rest of the day. Can't see, there should be one in this hole over here. Ooh. Saw a freaking woodpecker. Oh, there's so many fish here. There's so many gills. I gotta imagine there's a bass or some decent size. Dropped to the bottom, about a 1/8 weight, but yeah, I see a bass already. If I don't catch any today, I'm gonna say it's like a fishing. Gotta be gunked down there. I can't fish through any of it if I can call on something. It's so hard to find a spot here. Right now, that's not covered in friggin' slime. or gunk. Solid fish.
Did you catch anything?
Not yet. Nothing yet. There's a bunch of fish around though. Yeah, if you just like step over there, there's like 100 like blue eels and stuff.
Oh, I know. I was on the dock right there, and I was throwing right over here in the shallow where you at, and I got a few hits a little while ago.
There's fish here for sure.
Yeah. Well, good luck. I got lots of fish.
Thank you. That's good to know that someone's at least getting bites. I feel like this spot is a lot deeper water there. Can't tell if the water is cold or not. Water's still nice and cool, comparable to everything else. So, I'm just have to change spots. We'll see. I'm gonna go fish another spot. So we're back at another spot. We're across the way from where we last were. It's a lot more loud. There seems to be bigger fish. Saw one big one already. That's a 3 or 4 pounder. Didn't see much besides that, but I'm good with quality over quantity. If they bite. There's so much muck stuff here. I'm gonna make a move though down the way. It just blew up there. I think it was a gill. Lots of gills. Oh, there's a bass. There's a good bass. He's chasing those gills too. I don't know where he went. I don't know if he's on this brush pile. Watch a gill going after this though. Oh,
get off their knees now, man.
I don't know where he ran off to. Come back here in like 15 minutes. I know where the fish are. Get another bite to another part. Find fish to eat. Get another bite at this point. It's hard. Thank you.
Hey guys, this is the end of the video. You know, I kind of cut it off abruptly. I don't know how to say the word. But I really just, I wanted to not just leave it like that. I wanted to talk about fishing the tackle I was using. Of course you can go to my TikTok, and there's probably a video out by now all about both of my setups, giving you the exact names and how you write them. I will also leave them in the description below of my baits and tackle, you know. So I was fishing a bottom hopper or a finesse worm type thing. Whatever Berkeley is like version of the Zoom finesse worm is on both the rigs in like a June bug color. So I have a favorite rigged rod. It's also known as the Phantom rod. It's a Phantom rigged rod. It was John B's rod when they were still a favorite. I thought it was a cool rod. I mean, that's cool. He has a really good casting combo of it too, if you can find one. They're usually pretty good. But it's a 6-stick reel on it. Didn't want to blend out for the Phantom. Actually, it's just given to me. My favorite. Thank you, favorite. That's why I use all their stuff. But the backing is 10 pound vicious no feed braid in a high vis yellow. And then it goes down to 8 pounds. I use that pretty much on my finesse. It's a 1/8 ounce circle or cylinder weight to a VMC Nico finesse Nico hook. And then put that there. This is where it gets kind of interesting. This is a Defender rod. My favorite, of course. This is a Shimano Sedona. I like it. It's really good for the money. I do. It's just American. God. But it's, I think it's like 15 pound braid on the back. I don't know why. There's really no difference for me. I use a super long leader. So then it goes down. I think it's 12 pound fluorocarbon. It goes to a Berkeley bottom hopper, or not bottom hopper, Berkeley shaky head weight and a cylinder head. That's 1/8 too. That's pretty much it. You know, that's the stuff I was using. Links will be in the description for all of it. I just want to thank you guys for watching. If you got this far, like, subscribe, do all that stuff. Thank you guys.